Are you thinking about selling your home and wondering what it actually costs to sell your home? Today, I'm going to share with you the true costs of selling your home. The first expense that you should plan for when selling your home, if you're not selling your home yourself, is the real estate commission. Real estate commission completely depends on what you agree with your listing agent. Another thing that you should plan on when it comes to selling your home are any home repair costs. If there's something you know that needs to be repaired, I would just recommend get it done, repair it before it goes on the market. More than likely, the buyer is going to hire a home inspector to do an overall look at the inside and outside of the home from top to bottom. So that inspector will likely call out any repairs and they might ask you, and you might end up having to negotiate to get that done anyways. Common things are electrical work, roof, furnace, air conditioning, those kind of things, plumbing, if you have a leak. Those are things that you can anticipate maybe a buyer asking for to be repaired. Now on the bigger side of that, like foundation, if you have a crack in the foundation, you might have to plan a couple thousand dollars to get that crack sealed and fixed. Another thing is utilities. If you're moving out of your home, maybe you're moving to another state and you have to start a new job before the sale of the home is even done, make sure you plan and budget for your utilities to stay on. Most lending programs, different kinds of loan, FHA, VA, conventional, you'll need to have the utilities on so that the appraiser can make sure that utilities are to the home. Even a home inspector, if the buyer hires a home inspector, they're gonna check and see if the water turns on, if toilets are flushing good, do lights turn on. So make sure that you budget and plan for those utilities, even if the home is going to be vacant. Closing costs and any additional fees related to that. So here in Montana, we're a title company state. We use the title company for closings. The wonderful escrow officers there balance all of that. The closing fees are gonna be prorated taxes, the fees charged by the title company, those kind of things. So you need to ask your agent, if you're not in the Billings market, if you're somewhere else, what are the approximate closing fees and prorated taxes and all of that that you're gonna have to pay at closing. If you are selling your home maybe out of town a little bit, consider things like propane, or if you have a cistern, oftentimes a buyer will want the propane tank to be filled or a cistern to be filled. Other times that stuff can be agreed to be prorated, so keep that in mind. The capital gains tax. Now, I am no accountant. I don't know much about taxes, so thank goodness for my accountant because she's amazing. But if you have owned your home less than 2 years and you're selling it, you will have a capital gains tax. So find out if the reason you're moving, if you have any tax breaks when it comes to that. If you're required to move for certain reasons, you might be able to avoid the capital gains tax, but it's definitely something you want to ask your accountant on so you know how much is going to be taxed on the sale of your home. All right, those are just some ideas to keep in mind with the costs of selling your home. If you have any questions, my contact information is below. I would love to chat with you about selling your home and what your goals are. Make sure you click to subscribe and stay tuned. I have a lot of great videos coming up, including my Ride With Me series. Until next time, bye.